you already done the function decomposition, you read, and you already made the morphological chart. I hope you already conducted your meeting session using GEMBOARD, producing the function decomposition and also your morphological chart. And I hope it's already completed. So by now, you must be completed. Your morphological chart, is already completed. Like I shown yang tu lah, like this one. Actually, you dah completed you punya morphological chart. Okay, you already done. Using your GEMBOARD. I hope you already buat video. You already done video recording. Hopefully, ask you to do video recording and for your documentation. Okay, you should do video recording on your discussion. And so this your completed morphological chart. Okay, as I mentioned to you, morphological chart ni, you have a lot of unlimited number of solution. Unlimited number of solution. If you look on this morphological chart, you have unlimited number because we have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Kita punya 7 rows of kita our sub function. Okay, this one already discussed in class. Based on our function decomposition, place count in order, mix the food, store the food. How do we store, transfer the food? How do we distribute the food equally? And how we position the food so the food is not misplaced. And also how we remove excessive food. So you already fill in. This all the. I hope you guys for your knee, you should have 8 column is much better lah. Macam this one I have 7 columns. Each column is much better. So you throw out all the ideas. So you all the fill in all the idea possible ideas based on the sub function. So you sketch on your chart here. Okay, you sketch on your chart. Everything is there. So after you have completed, if you look on, if you fill in all these possible solution, this what we call solution or ideas, you throw down and you sketch it on your chart here, in your chart. So when you are completed, so you have the result from here is that you have unlimited number of solution. I mean, kalau if you learn probability metric, you have 7 rows and 8 columns. That is, it means the number of solution is hundreds and thousands. Is quite unlimited, hundreds and thousands of solutions. So from here you get some picture, daripada sini you get some idea. You have, because you already throw out all the possible idea based on the sub functions. After the result from here is that it gives you a lot of solution for you to combine all these sub function into complete system. So it gives you a lot of ideas, unlimited number of ideas. Because we have 7 rows and like this one, 7 column. You mean about 100,000 solution. You combine all possible solution. You combine the possible, you link this one to become a complete function. So you have unlimited, the point is unlimited number of solution. Okay, kalau that you have from morphological chart, it gives us some picture and idea to produce unlimited number of solutions. So it's good for you from now on. After this, you and your team members can have look into this morphological chart. And I mean, each team member, kalau you get only one solution from here, I didn't say it's totally wrong, tetapi it's kind like membazir jugalah. Betul tak? Kind like wasting. Why? Because you have unlimited number of solution. What? You only develop, each team member only develop one solution. That is the minimum requirement. Which one that suits you, and which one that you think this is, you yourself think, you combine all these sub function, you think this is the one you want to develop. So you have one solution. Tetapi as I told you again and again, from this morphology, there are unlimited number, lot of solution. Tapi kind like, to me, kind like if each team member develop one solution, I didn't say it's totally wrong, tetapi kind like wasting juga. But so design ni kalau boleh, the more solution that you can produce, the much better it is, because design ni is a process yang kita cakap, solving problem by generating ideas, solutions banyak, by generating a lot of ideas or solution, and we find the best one. Tapi kalau you have five member of you, plus maybe you have AHIP, maybe six, AHIP student. Kalau you have five of you or six of you, so each one of you one solution, it mean you can only produce five ideas or six ideas. So that six ideas, then kemudian from there we evaluate, then we find the best one. Tapi kalau each one of you katakan produce two ideas, let's say two ideas. From this morphological chart, it give you, each one of you give you two or three ideas. Kata, let's say minimum is two ideas. So it mean you have 10 solution kalau you five of you. So that 10 solution, then kemudian kalau you evaluate that on next week, through evaluation process, say you have the best, maybe the best 8, then kemudian you filter out the next stage, you have the best 5, kemudian you filter out, you have the best 3, then kemudian you have the best, from the best 3, you have the final best of the best. Itu much, much more better, because you begin with a lot, with 12 ideas, for example, rather than 6 ideas, atau rather than 5 ideas. So like I cakap, kalau one of you can produce a lot of ideas, from here you can produce two ideas or three ideas, that is good. I encourage you guys, not just one idea. So you do a lot of sketching lah. Right after this, you will do a lot of sketching. From here, give you what you punya concept that you want to develop. Give you some ideas, some picture lah from this morphological chart. Which one that you want to develop. It give you a lot of solution from here. Rather than from at the beginning, we have nothing. We don't have what is our solution. From here, maybe it gives some picture, give you some direction, which concept you want to develop. So it's good you have this morphological chart. I hope your morphological chart is already ready. It must be done by now. Okay, but now I want to explain to you, from your completed morphological chart, so each one of you, your team member, each of your team member will develop ideas. As I told again, minimum one, tetapi saya tak galak sangat kalau one lah. I encourage you guys is to go for two ideas or at least or three ideas each one. So you mean kalau you five, you mean 15 ideas you have. Which is much better. Okay, bila sekarang ni for morphological chart, you develop ideas, you combine all the sub-function into complete function lah, into complete system. Okay, sub-function into complete function lah, into complete main system. You punya either project, you apa tu, feeding, cow feeding device, and the other group is cow basing. So you and your team member, okay, each team member, you can work independently. At this moment, from completed morphological chart, you and your team member, each team member can work independently to develop his or her own idea. Faham guys, class? Hello? Are you listening or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you and your team member, each team member can independently, boleh, you can develop your own base from this morphological. Maybe you can produce each one, or you can produce two or three ideas. Itu I encourage you guys, three ideas. Kemudian next week, you come back together, sit down as one team, then you discuss and you evaluate which ideas is better lah. Evaluate each idea. Alright, okay, at this moment, bila you develop you punya own ideas, because morphological chart is just a sketching. What we call this is ideation sketches lah. Sketching yang kita put in morphological chart is just like a cartoon sketching. Rough sketching kan, macam you put all on in the cell. You put all your sketches, maybe handwritten. Sometimes sketching in morphological chart, not just sketches. Maybe it's a handwritten sketching plus description. Plus you write something, description, to explain on all your rough sketch in the cell. Tapi from here, after you complete your PDS, your morphological chart, from this, you will develop, each team member will look on this, give you some picture to develop you punya whole main system. You join all the link lah. As shown, the other link you join. Okay, you want to develop this, okay, you have this solution one. Another one, maybe you are the, okay, you have solution two, so maybe you have three, you have solution three. Okay, you can work independently at this moment, you can sketch the idea. Ideas yang sketching yang in this morphology chart is just a simple sketching, what you call ideation sketch lah. Ideation sketch. Tapi kalau itulah, from this morphological chart, you want to develop you punya own ideas, you combine, okay, because this, okay, at this moment, your sketching need to be proper sketching lah, no longer sketching like in this morphological chart. You got to sketch your ideas more properly. Okay, if you look on the note that I share to you, ada kan, I share to you in the, apa tu, hold on adakah yang mana? No, this one. Mana dia? Just the sketching tu. Mana dia idea? Oh, ini. Ada kan? Ini your WhatsApp. Hello, class.
Ada.
Ada, ada.
Okay, let me show you the two. Hold on, yeah. You can see this slide. Can you see this basic sketching technique for yesterday?
Ada nampak ni? Yeah.
All right. Okay, this one I already put here in your WhatsApp. Okay, at this moment after the morphological chart. Morphological chart tu pasal we have type of sketching guys. We have type of sketching. Okay, the first one is about ideation sketch. Ini yang kartuni saya lah. Ideation sketch ni sebenarnya is a very rough sketching. Very rough sketching. Macam yang you put in your morphological chart. Just like schematic diagram kan, morphological chart you put in each cell tu. You pernah kan, during your conduct your jamboard when you produce your morphological chart. You fill in all idea possible added in all sub function there. You throw out all idea. You and your group member actively participating lah. Throw you fill in all the possible and you fill in your complete in your morphological chart. So that idea that you sketch in the morphological is just ideation sketch, very rough sketch. Maybe a rough feature. Maybe you and your group member very rough idea. It's not a proper sketching lah. That is what you call ideation sketch. Ideation sketch also implement on the case sometimes kalau you as a you alone sometimes when you are sitting kadang-kadang you need sometimes it pop ups in your mind, you have some idea solution how to solve your punya design problem for your project. So you quickly get any paper that you can access, small paper, A4 paper, and you can do, and you do some little bit ideation sketch. It's just a rough sketch, it's not proper sketch, only you understand what the sketching. It can be 2D, it can be 3D, just a basic conteng-conteng lah kita cakap, very rough idea. So you yourself saja understand lah, because sometimes kalau you tak straight away jot down on the paper, tak sketch on the paper, your ideas tu will be, you will lose it. You cannot simpan dalam kepala, you cannot just keep, tak boleh. Tomorrow morning when you wake up, your idea get lost. Yeah, you will lose your idea. So to make sure that you always jot down on the paper, that's why you call ideation sketch. You simply straight away you sketch. And you sketch it rough sketching. Only you yang understand. When you show your sketch to other people, they don't understand. Pasal you just jot down whatever. Itu addition. Itu yang very beginning to sketch. Can do on any paper lah. For any paper that you can get. Okay, yang I cakap tadi yang the next is explorative. Explorative sketches means okay, bila you punya okay lah, daripada morphological chart tu kan, you fill in all in the cell to its ideation sketch. Okay, from after morphological chart is completed, so it give you ideas to develop lot of solution. Okay, you want to develop this solution, then you want to this one you need to properly sketch it. This one you need like paper like A3 lah and sketching pencil. I explain to you what tools you need for sketch. Then you need to sketch it properly. You mean you explore more because you, macam for example, you are doing field device. You explore what is pasal ideation sketch in morphological chart. It's just a rough sketch. Okay, from that completed morphological chart, you join all the link. Okay, it give you some picture. Oh, you want to develop this main system. The whole when you combine together all the sub function. Okay, you want to develop. Now you proper sketch. It means that this one you got to explore. Your sketching, you have got to explore what component. Because from your morphological, you join this sub-function, you know the component from your ideation rough sketch on your set in your cell, right? But now your sketching have to be proper lah. This one better explain about what you going to design, you punya concept. So you explore more. You have to identify what is the component, the fence, the platform, the size of the bar, the feeding system, the tank. The flow system, the conveying the food system. You maybe sketch component on one paper. This one you need bigger paper like A3 at least lah, and you need sketching pencil. So you sketch part by part, sketch a little bit lah. What is the possible component involved? Because for morphological chart, give that is just ideation sketches, right? So when you do proper sketching, this is what you call explore. When you explore ni, you sketch ni more like not 2D punya sketching, not 2D schematic diagram. It's more like representing apa, like a 3D representation in 3D representation, like isometric. Itu macam you ada kind like isometric drawing, the 3D representation of your sketching. So it give you proper view for proper you to identify. You mean you explore all the possible colors. You sketch, maybe there is a cylinder, there is a bar, there is a fan. You sketch fan, what is the location, what is how this fan located, how they attach, where is the location of the food container, how the you convey the food from there, you explore what is a possible component. This is what we call explorative sketch. Okay, whatever component, more detail, you mean more detail sketching. So this kind of sketching, you can discuss with your team member. This kind of sketching, explorative sketch, I mean, you are able to communicate with your team member or with your client or with your lecturer. You can present your idea, because ideation sketch in morphology or your ideation sketch yang at beginning tadi is just a rough. You only, you person will only understand what is it, because you don't want to, you punya idea to get lost macam tu. You again, because you just straight away jot down rough idea. But the second stage, you make explore. Explore means you explore. You make more detailed sketches of your component. Okay, itu yang more representative ni lah. More proper punya sketching in 3D isometric or perspective view. Okay, later I show you how to create basic about perspective view. Okay, this is what we call explore. We identify all the possible component yang involved in our design. Understand, Iqbal? Pak Mahat, apa yang saya kata? Hello? Yes, sir. Sound clear ke?
Clear.
Clear, Dr. Clear.
Yeah, okay, itu yang explorative sketch. Explorative sketch. Okay, then another one, explanatory sketches. Explanatory sketches ni, you mean your sketches ni, yang tadi explore. Explore ni like you pecah-pecah your component, possible component involved. Your component, how the, what component involved. Yeah. Explore mean ni, more your sketches tu, dia like, bukan hanya explore tau. Your sketches tu, you have, your sketching ni also proper sketching. Maybe you represent in perspective view, not 2D, 2D view. Macam explore tadi pun perspective view, 3D view of your each component. Explanatory sketches, they more and explain. I mean your sketches, your sketch must able to explain how it works. Macam you not just sketching, your sketching also have kind like other illustration, other description, that kind like other, the, it shows something, they explain, it pull of text also, not just sketching. Other text, other description showing how the mechanism work, how the system work. Macam you have a cow enter this path, you show some flow of the cow, so some sketches, you don't need to sketch the cow properly, maybe you can sketch a simple format version of cow, maybe you can show some arrow, the cow flow to this path, narrow path, and this path, and the cow enter to this cell, and this one, okay, then the food tank, you show some arrow, the food will transfer, step number two, the food will transfer, then will be opening valve, nampak tak, dia ada kind, not just sketches, dia ada explanation, ada arrow, ada kind like apa, showing like dia punya flow of dia punya mechanism, understand what I mean? Explain auditory sketch, they explain how it work, understand guys?
Yes, I understand.
Yang lain paham tak? Yang lain dengar ke?
Dengar.
Itu explain. Satu explore. Explore, you identify component. Sketches tu in 3D jugalah. 3D of you punya ni. Itu buka ideation sketches yang paling rough mula-mula tadi. Macam your morphology kita chart tu is ideation. Just rough-rough sketches. Okay. Yang tu you explore, you identify all the component. Then kemudian they explain. You mean your sketches been able to explain. So this one kind of sketches I need you guys to produce lah. Morphological chart already done. That means your ideation sketches lah. Morphological chart, everything in the cell to ideation. It means sekarang ni, you kena produce sketches each one of you. Guys, kalau boleh each one of you, minimumnya one ni lah, one solution. Tapi I encourage you guys, I galakkan Kalau one, each one of team member can produce 2-3 solution, that is much better. So what you need to do, each one of you, team member ni, you kena produce sketches tau. You kena produce sketches, explain and explore. Explore and explain, itu yang kena buat. Ini yang kena, I will assess nanti individual concept. If you look, you punya my mapping on you punya, in your, I already post kan, you punya mapping, punya markah tu. In the Excel files, if look individual sketches, individual ideas carry 15 points. 15 points of individual sketches. So it means you have to produce, kalau 15 points, that is a big of your total grade. So it means you need to produce 3 sketches. Remember, individual sketching, because you punya individual concept tu ada point on it. 15 points of your total grade. So kalau 15 points, kita divide by 3, 5, 5, 5. So how many sketches do we need? Rasa? Yeah, 3 sketches we need. Okay, you, each solution that you have, produce 3 sketches. Okay, when to produce that 3 sketches nanti dulu. Hold on dulu. Alright, the first thing to do is that, okay, bila What you need to do after morphological chart, hold on dulu eh. Nanti dulu. Bila when you to produce that three sketches nanti dulu. You got to do brainstorming session dulu. Before you produce that three sketches. Macam ni eh. Mula-mula you don't produce that three sketches. What you do, you mula dengan A4 dulu. Pasal nanti later yang three sketches tu, I need it in A3. You have to do in A3 punya kertas eh. And sketching pencil. Okay, mula-mula punya tu, the first two, after morphology completed, you have idea. Each one of you have idea. You sit down, okay, you work dulu on A4 dulu. One piece saja. We need only one piece of A4 paper, not A3. You sketch dulu you punya basic ideas after you combine all the sub-function that you get some idea from the morphological chart. So you have you punya solution. You sketch dulu on one piece of paper dulu. In 3D and so on lah. In 3D and so on. Lepas tu, you will conduct a brainstorming. Okay, how do we conduct a brainstorming? Macam ni eh.
Hold on.
Okay, you boleh nampak my live video boleh nampaknya eh. Hold on je. Boleh nampak live video ni?
Boleh, Doktor.
Boleh, Doktor.
Nampak jelas kan? Okay. Okay, brainstorming tu macam mana? How do you conduct a brainstorming? Mula-mula buat brainstorming dulu. Sketching tu nanti dulu. Yang sketching 3 tu nanti dulu. Itu after the brainstorming. Then you buat proper 3 sketches. Okay, brainstorming. How do you conduct brainstorming? Okay. Tapi syarat dia, when you do, before you do brainstorming, your morphological chart tu dah completed, already done. I mean, your session yang tu dah buat ke belum ni? Korang ni? Dah buat ke? Itu dah penuh kan?
Dah.
You dah share kat saya WhatsApp kan? Tapi sorry saya tak check lagi. Tapi dah completed kan? Dah penuh Excel kan? Okay, from there you and your team member have some idea to develop. Betul tak?
Betul.
Ah betul, okay? Okay. Mula-mula, okay. Sebenarnya saya cakap each one, kalau boleh three concept. Katakanlah minimum. I'm talking ni scenario dia, minimum lah one concept. Scenario concept, okay. From that completed morphology chart, each one of you have some idea to develop lah. You combine dengan all that sub-function, betul eh? Each one of you. Okay, you sit down together. You sit down. You sketch dulu on piece of paper A4 dulu. You sketch the idea that you want to develop on single piece A4 saja, no need A3. Itu mula-mula. Pasal itu masih lagi rough idea lagi. Okay, tapi that piece, single piece paper A4 tu, that rough idea tu, you can communicate with your team member. It means, kalau you sketch that one, when you send to your team member B, you under one group at team of 5, you send to team member B. So it means your team member B, your friend, your team member A, your team member B, when you read, you punya, you give your sketch to that your B, team member B, he can understand. It means your sketching ni ada illustration, ada description, ada written juga, not just figure saja. You understand what I mean? Even in single piece of A4, ada some explanation, ada handwritten. So when you give to B, student B, student B read, they can understand apa you punya sketching. Understand tak? Clear tak?
Clear.
One piece of A4 paper dulu. You sketch idea. So brainstorming session ni, dia macam ni. I hope you tahu sebenarnya you dah, I think pernah buat kan. Brainstorming ni bukan kita cakap brainstorming, discuss-discuss brainstorming. That's not brainstorming. Brainstorming actually like this. Brainstorming, you sit down. Round corner lah. Kalau face to face memang macam this. Yeah? You sit down. You student A. Yeah? A, student B, student C, student D, student E. Sit round the table lah. Dia 5 minute break, 5 minute break. Okay, mula-mula first kali. Okay, this is student B. Okay, you mula-mula you sketch one piece of paper dulu, you punya idea lah. That's the first thing lah, first round eh, first round. Tengok sini eh. Then you sit down together. Okay, you can handle it because you are online kan. You can do this by platform is, how do you do the platform? Webex pun boleh lah. You send you punya sketching through, you send your sketching by apa? Jambot. Apa platform you pakai dulu? Jambot eh? Jambot eh?
Sketching, Jambot ataupun present kat Google Meet tu.
Tapi tak, your sketching tu by hand on paper, bukan sketching on Jamboard.
Oh, sketching nampak by Google Meet.
Pakai Google Meet or WeChat lah. How do you send, macam katakan let's say this is virtual, how do you do this? You pass around this pass here, this pass here, this pass here, this pass here. You know how to handle that, itu kan? Your creativity, what platform you want to use, your creativity. I don't necessarily Jamboard. Jamboard like morphological chart, yes. You can draw, you can throw out ideas, boleh you sketch. I'm not sure lah apa, maybe you can use Jamboard, or maybe you can WeChat or Zoom lah. Okay, the point is like this. Okay, you student A, your friend B, C, D, E, you under one group. Okay, you sketch your idea cakap, single piece of paper. Okay, effort saja, you sketch your punya idea. Dan kemudian you sit down together, first sesi eh. First sesi of brainstorming, A will send, A will pass his idea to B. Okay, ni A punya sketches. We were it. Ini A punya sketches. Okay. A punya sketches. Ini student A punya sketches. Then will B will get A pass B to A lah. B will send dia punya ni. B to B punya sketches. Ni B punya sketches. C will get. Okay. C will send to ni lah. I hope you understand what I mean lah. C will send. D will get the C punya sketches. Okay. C punya sketches. E will get. E will get the D punya sketches. Okay. Yang A will get student E punya sketches. Asal? Macam tu eh. So, you first round. Okay. Bila first sesi ni, when the B receive the A sketches, and each one of you, C receive B sketches, C receive D and so on, and A receive E sketches. Okay. The rules of brainstorming, when, okay, B, when you receive A sketches, student B, eh? When you receive A sketches, rules dia do not, apa? Do not condemn. What I mean, what you mean by do not condemn? What do you mean by condemn? It means do not kill the sesi of brainstorming. The idea of brainstorming, we try to make things better. Faham tak? Understand, are you listening class?
Yes, sir.
Dengar.
When we receive A sketches, do not condemn. Dia bukan condemn, guys. Do not comment. You comment, make it positive. Give positive value. You added the thing. Kalau you compliment pun, not good. Kata cakap, oh, this good idea. This good. Oh, brilliant, brilliant, good idea. I like it very much. I like it pretty much. Pun also not good. You, kita give, kita make things better. Do not, the first thing, the first rule, do not comment. Do not make positive statement condemn. Kalau you condemn, you kill. You kill the creativity of the each person. They feel demotivated. The rule is that when you look at like B, when you receive the B, when you receive the air sketches, when you look at it, you look at it, you look at in term of positive side. Do not condemn. Eh? Because memanglah kita ni, kita short sendiri dengan kita punya konsep. Kan? Kita always, kita memang everybody have their own prejudice. Okay. When you look at somebody comment, you always try to, this one will not work, this not work. Cannot, you cannot condemn that, this will not work. Do not put a statement on his sketches or her sketches, this will not work, this not done, this is rubbish, cannot. Somebody ada orang tu pedas, eh? No, cannot be like that. You kill it. You put, okay, you cakap, this is good, the idea is good, but it's much better kalau if you add something. This is much better if you reduce it. I think the component is too kind like complicated. Try to reduce component, but the function is okay to maintain the function. Ataupun you give, you understand what I mean? You give, apa? Do not condemn. Give positive. Bukan compliment also no. Kalau compliment doesn't, dia tak boleh enhance. Eh? If you compliment, oh this is brilliant, this is good, this is good. No, dia tak boleh. Also the second round when student A receive dia punya sketching being evaluated by B, C, D and E. Kalau everybody give compliment, A cannot see apa lagi dia boleh enhance dia punya konsep. You understand what I mean?
Yes, sir.
Understand tak, guys? Yang lain faham tak? Eh? Kalau semua compliment pun cannot do. Kalau semua condemn lagi hancur lah. Tak boleh. Kalau semua give or negative comment also no. Give, try to comment, look on your punya friend punya gestures. Try to do to positive, give positive. Apa kita cakap? Positive comment lah, kan? Positive comments, eh? Positive kan? And value added. You understand what I mean? Value added. Value added, I mean, you try to make things improve better. Jangan condemn. Condemn cakap, this is not good. This is rubbish. Cannot be done. This will not work. No. That kind of statement. You look, you try look at his or her concept, you study it, and you put something like, You put a statement. You put a statement. Macam B, when you receive A sketches, you put a statement saying that the sketching, it, they, like I told you just now, like, their feature is kind of like complicated, but should put a little bit reduced component, so it's less complicated. That one kind of comment is okay. You understand what I mean? Dia bukan kill, so do not kill. Kill lain. Kill, you cakap this will not work. Tak boleh lah, because nanti you baru first round A send to B, B first round B send to C, C send to D. You have to go to their 5-minute break. Macam ni, first round B receive A, say B will do 5 minutes, stop, receive each one of you 5 minutes, take you do some comment lah. Comment on you punya friend punya concept. Okay, it's good kalau macam ni, B you punya return dia, B punya statement return dia blue color. Understand me? Ni you pakai Jambot lah, I think Jambot lah you punya platform. Any comment tu blue color, understand tak? From B. Tak apa, it's okay. A tahu B make a statement like this. Pasal dia, you, kawan you bukan not condemning, give positive value. Clear tak guys? Any statement by B blue color. Understand? Any written by C green color. You can do that by Jambot lah kan?
Betul.
You understand what I'm talking about?
Hello.
Hello, can you, are you listen, boleh dengar ke?
Boleh lah.
Right. Okay, any B, when you receive a sketch here, you make a statement, you blue color. Can. C, kalau you receive B, C, any statement, positive comment from C statement, green color. Ha, macam tu. C, any statement, C punya statement, green color lah. Kalau D, you punya red color. Jadi, jadi, bila you go to 5 session, dia macam ni, you send you 5 minute, make some comment, positive comment, do not condemn. Kemudian, stop. Lepas tu, give your punya, okay. B, kemudian, macam ni, the first session, A send to B. First minute, macam ni cerita lah, so make you understand. Ni bukan macam ni lah. Ni saya cakap student A saja, student A sketch. Tapi, semua involved, semua involved. Semua involved. So, it will begin like this. First session, okay, first session, A send to B. So B make up statement in blue color. Positive statement, give value added. Do not condemn. Do not compliment saja pun tak boleh. Compliment, give some, make improve better. Dia punya features of your friend A. Stop, 5 minutes. You dah, B dah already done evaluated lah, evaluation. Okay, then stop. Lepas tu, break. Lepas tu break. B send A sketches. B send A sketches, okay, receive, C will receive A sketches have been evaluated by B, kan? Jadi C akan put a statement lah, C akan put statement. Lepas tu stop, C akan send A sketches to D. So D will receive A, student A punya sketches being evaluated by B, being evaluated by C, being evaluated by D. Faham tak? Kelas. Stop. Lepas tu send pula. Yang ini student E akan receive A punya sketches being evaluated by B, being evaluated by C, by D, and E make statement. Then stop, send pula. Lepas tu A akan get back his, understand tak guys? A akan get back his original sketches being evaluated by C, D, E. Semua dah evaluated. Ada statement on dia punya sketches. Bukan hand written lah, I mean. Understand tak?
Understand.
Jadi ini I'm talking about student A, tapi each one the same case lah. Each one the same case lah. We stop. Macam tadi B, B send to C kan. B punya being related. At the end, after 5 round, B akan, okay, you buat some comment, positive comment. Do not, okay, do not condemn. Do not compliment pun tak boleh. Compliment je, tapi give some value added. Make things better on you punya friend yang concept. Understand? B pun sama. You akan receive after 5 round, you akan receive you punya sketches being evaluated by C, D, E and A. C sama, being evaluated by D, E, A and D. Semua sama. You akan back after 5 round. Dan ni, you akan receive balik your sketching. You akan receive balik your original sketching being evaluated. They give some value added. Bukan condemn, bukan compliment saja pun also not good. Value added make things better. Maybe it's reduce component, improve certain function, kan? Some recommendation and improvement. Understand class? That is brainstorming. Clear tak?
Clear tu.
Clear okay, ni you kena conduct lah benda ni. You kena conduct right after this class, kena buat lah. You kena buat di sesi Dan tak, you boleh pakai Jamboard. I think Jamboard lah pasal you ada boleh handwritten. Kalau Jamboard can do that, you do Jamboard lah. So you kena conduct this brainstorming session. Okay, tak cakap. Mula-mula yang sketching yang you produce during ni, sketching ni just one piece of A4 je lah. Just a basic sketching lah. Sketching ada. Okay, my point is after this sesi brainstorming, after 5 rounds, you will receive balik you punya original idea lah. Okay, A, for example, student A, you will receive after you punya brainstorming session, you receive your sketching, your punya ideas tu being evaluated by all the 4 of your group members. So, it give back to you. Okay, the point tu saya cakap, jangan condemn. Kalau you condemn, A kalau receive balik, semua hentam dia. Everybody cakap condemn, it is rubbish ni kan. Sebenarnya, yang saya cakap blue, green, green colour ni bukan, jangan hentam. Kalau dia hentam, dia tengok, oh green colour from student B. Oh dia tahu dia ni anti aku ke, dia letak, dia hentam. Tak boleh cakap dia hentam, give positive comment lah. And to enhance and to make dia punya original concept tu better. C also, when you tengok, tengok A kau punya sketches, you tambah lagi. C when you receive, when you receive A sketches being evaluated by B, you tengok B already make a statement about this. You tengok lagi. Understand what I mean? See what I mean, I'm talking about student A. See when you receive A sketches being evaluated by B, B already made them. Oh, I think I want to comment. B already comment on this. Positive comment. I didn't say negative comment. Oh, I want to add more. See, you add more. Add more thing. Apa yang B forget to add. Understand what I mean? Understand tak kelas?
Yes, I understand.
Faham eh? Macam tu lah. You tambahkan. You add more. When you receive D, tengok. D, when you receive A sketches being related by B, C and D, tengok apa yang they already mentioned to enhance the A sketch idea, you add more lagi. That's the beauty of it. Nanti A, when A they receive back, being evaluated by all these B, C, D and E, they tengok dia punya tu, oh yeah, they are right, yes. Yeah, I will do improvement lah. Then you see can lot of thing value added lah. It mean positive comment. And then maybe reduce component. Based on the comment A, when you receive back your original, each one of you, when you receive back all you punya original sketches being evaluated, being value added, ada some statement, value added recommendation, some positive comment, then it give you a better clear picture to make your concept much better lah. Then only you can enhance you punya concept. Understand guys? After brainstorming, then only you gunakan sketching A3 lah. Yang itu saya cakap tadi, explorative sketch, ada explanatory sketch, yang 3 version of sketching. Then after this, only each of you develop individual concept. Faham kelas? Clear or not?
Clear, Doctor.
Alright. Then you develop. Now after this, when you receive back you punya original sketches being evaluated by all your team members, then only you develop based on their comment. Give you some new idea to improve you punya your ideas, to improve your concept lah. I give you better. Then only you make a proper sketching. You make a proper scan. That's why that is the individual. This one, right after this, itu yang saya nak tengok, that 3 version of sketches of individuals. Not masa moment brainstorming, only A4 lah. Only A4. Understand eh? Rough sketches sajalah. Tapi rough sketches tu based on the morphological chart lah, what the picture you have. Alright. Understand eh? After that tu, so saya cakap ini first round lah. Kalau just banyak brainstorming ni, kalau you have 2, 3, 4 stages lagi much better lah. Katakan satu konsep one. Kai cakap, remember guys, kai cakap dengan you. Kelas. Kai cakap kalau boleh each one of you bukan one solution lah. Kalau you have 2 solution, how many brainstorming you have? Kalau you have 2 solution each one of you, how many brainstorming sesi? 2 sesi lah.
2 sesi.
Yang ni one sesi, ni one session, one solution. Kan each one of you one solution only kan. Kalau you have 2 solution, kata each one of you have 2 solution. You have to go to another round of the other 2 sesi of brainstorming. Understand tak?
Yes,
faham.
Faham kan? 2 sesi of brainstorming. Ini solution B pula. First tadi brainstorming 1 sesi, solution number 1. Each, katakan let's say each one of you 2 solution. I like it kalau you want more than one, each one of you 2 or 3. Kalau 3 lagi longer tapi much better lah, it takes time lah. Okay, katakan each one of you 2 solution. Okay, sesi brainstorming, first brainstorming sesi for solution number 1 each one of you. Make ada you lah, nanti 5 round ni, you go back originally. Okay, sekarang kita conduct brainstorming sesi number 2. For solution 2, our solution number 2. Buat again like this, tapi this one solution number 2. Understand eh? Faham eh? Alright. Okay. After you are done brainstorming, itu saya cakap, then only you produce then only you produce 3 sketches. Ini yang individual sketches yang need to see lah, yang 5.5.5.1 carry. It's good, right? Then you need 3 sketches. Okay. Number one, about sketching guys. I want to tell you frankly. Kau nampak tak pensel yang saya pakai ni?
Nampak.
Pensel ni, ini bukan sebarangan pensel. Ini 7B Faber-Castell. Ada code number ni. Ini 3B. Because I'm talking now about sketching. Kalau you buy this pencil, you will appreciate sketching because you feel the difference. Dia punya, when you do sketching, dia punya toning of dia punya lead, the quality, the pressure, dia punya smoothness of the line when you sketching, you will appreciate sketching. You feel the beauty of sketching. Kalau you buy common pencil, the worst case of course lah, takkanlah sketching pakai mechanical pencil, patah the lead kan, nonsense. No sketching by mechanical pencil, no sketching by pen, no, and no sketching by, also I tell you frankly, no sketching by typical wooden pencil. Ini is typical, ini typical, no, this one also professional. Adalah typical wooden pencil. Jangan buy pencil for sketching. Kalau boleh, I encourage you guys, do not buy typical wooden pencil yang you get for retail shop, kedai runcit mana-mana, no. Yang macam Pilot, semua tu lah kan, Staedtler, no. You punya kedai ada stationery shop lah. Stationery shop apa you ada kat kedai? Macam sini we have Kiang, Rainbow, Book Talk, I don't know, you kat mana? Korang ni kat mana? Where are you?
UTM.
Most of you UTM eh? All of rumah. You in UK? Huh?
Rumah.
Alright, okay. Some of you in UTM, some of you in rumah kan? Kalau you are at rumah, you pick tempat, you have any stationery shop, you know. Stationery shop ni bukan bukan bookshop eh, bukan bookstore. Not popular, not tu, bukan. Stationery like Rainbow, Book Talk, you know. Kalau you pergi dekat mall normally, I think ada. Kalau you pergi dekat mana-mana shopping punya ni, ada stationery shop. Like macam, what stationery shop do you have at your place? This stationery shop ni, dia jual pensel, pen, ruler, all the stationery lah. Sharpener, eraser, protector, semua. Correction tape, ink, marker pen, semua. Pasal dia focus on stationery. Drawing paper, cardboard, benda tu. Itulah macam Book Talk, benda tu lah. Actually Book Talk ni dia ada part dia bookstore lah, tapi actually dia focus on stationery. Kalau you go to that stationery shop, okay, macam Kiang, Rainbow, Book Talk, okay, you go there, bila you go to that place, you cakap dengan sales guy or that sales guy or sales person lah, cakap, can you get me a sketching pencil? Can you get me a sketching pencil? Dia bukan common pencil guys, yeah, sketching pencil. Nanti, sometimes the sales guy, sales person there, they also not understand. They just bring you to common wooden pencil. No, I don't want that, this typical wooden pencil. When they bring you to the place where they sell common pencil, wooden pencil like Pilot, itu is common. No, I want a professional sketching pencil. Kau dengar tak ni? Boleh tak? Boleh buat tak ni? This is the first thing to do lah.
Boleh tak?
Okay. You pergi lah, after this guy pergi, you buat sketching. You nak buat sketching lah. Tapi yang masa brainstorming tadi, brainstorming tu tak apa, you can sketch on any pencil. Tetapi I'm talking after that brainstorming, understand what I mean? Where I need you to draw yang 3 sketches. Bila you receive balik you punya A4 paper punya sketching, then only you sketch on A3. That proper sketching tu, because that sketching, 3 sketches tu, your individual sketching idea tu, I need to assess it. Itu I evaluate that 3 sketches. First is full assembly, second is exploded, third is exploded. Nanti I explain to you. Itu satu yang second tu, explore second. Yes.
Kalau 2B tak boleh, dia memang kena 7B dengan 3B eh?
Ini I want to discuss. Okay, you go to that shop, you cakap dia, can you give me the professional sketching pencil? So, baru dia dia akan, mungkin dia tak faham, dia pergi tanya manager dia ke, yang more experience punya staff dia, dia akan, oh, you mean professional, they bring you to the other corner. Ni special. Even pencil pun sebenarnya ada high end lagi eh. Okay, for some of you, this first time you dengar ni kan, memang ada. First, kan? Even anak saya sekolah pun, sekolah menengah pun saya belikan dia. Dia form 2 itu, sekarang dia dah form 3 lah. Dia punya ada kerja sekolah daripada cikgu dia bagi about art, I don't know. I bought her the sketching pencil professional. Jadi dia punya hasil kerja tu very nice. And cikgu dia compliment, very nice. Nampak different dengan common pencil punya. Contohnya macam tu lah. That's right. Okay, so that sense person akan bring you to the other corner yang special punya. Dia bukan kat common. Dia kat belakang-belakang tu, other corner, dia ada sketching pencil. Sketching pencil ni macam ni. Dia yang brand ni, Faber Castell. Faber Castell, you go for 7B and satu lagi 3B or 2B. I need two version lah. Satu is yang make construction, satu yang darker one, 7B darker to make yang bold yang lebih ni lah. Make yang bold eh. Jangan ambil HB guys eh. Dan do not take HB. Sometimes sketching pencil you also has HB. HB stand for hardness, B stand for boldness. H ada 7H, 4H, 3H. Kan dia ada grade ikut number lah. 1, 2, 2H, 3H, 4H. Do not take H. H is hardness. H tak gelap. H is hardness. Hardness it mean the only, kalau the more harder, kalau you 7H it mean the more harder. Kalau the more harder it means dia bukan gelap tau. Dia more, the line is more solid. Dia more hardness of the lead. Tapi B stand for boldness. Boldness mean the boldness, it mean the darker. It's darker than 3B. So go for B. Eh, kalau you ambil, I need get two version. 2B on 7B. Jangan ambil 2B and 3B, jangan. Satu yang bawah 3B or 2B, satu 7B. Kita dia ada 8B, ada 9B if I'm not mistaken. Okay, this pencil I think it cost you RM2 sebatang aja. Boleh kan? Pasal you kalau buy common pencil yang Staedtler tu one box you can get for RM5. Betul lah kan? One box ada 10 pencil, 12 pencil. Betul kan? Itu common pencil. Itu tak seronok. When you do sketching, that one not good. You don't feel the good of sketching. Tapi kalau ini walaupun you ambil, you beli sebatang aja. RM2. Jangan jatuh patah habis lah. Dia punya lead internal patah. Be careful lah eh. Be careful. You beli sebatang. I think sebatang ni buat RM3. Invest sikit lah RM3 kan, takkan masalah RM3. Beli satu 7B, beli 2B. Cakap dia yang professional sketching pencil. Then your sketching will be nice. You feel the good of sketching. Pasal different tau, dia punya lead quality. Tapi you keep sharpen lah. Even you tak sharpen also, dia tumpul also. You make nice sketching, you can blend eh. Dia nicely dia punya tu. Boleh eh, itu the first thing to do. Kalau boleh lah eh. And good eraser lah. Eraser and you punya A3 paper. Yang brainstorming tadi tu A4, itu tak apalah. Brainstorming you can pencil biasa pun tak apa, just rough it, then you send to your friend. After you get back you punya A4 sketching tu, you being evaluated, then only you develop more detail lah. Then you punya each individual final punya sketching lah. After that evaluated by all your team members. Then you make proper sketching. Okay? Faham eh, kelas?
Faham later.
Faham later.
Alright. Okay, sekarang ni kita nak belajar sketching lah, cerita dia sekarang. Macam mana kita nak sketch? Korang pandai sketch tak? You know how to sketch, you have idea. Okay, let's say from F4 punya sketching, you send back to you after brainstorming. Been commented by all your team member, they give some value added positive comment. Then you have some idea to develop more, to improve you punya ni. Then you need to do proper sketching. You know how to sketch, kan? Yang mula-mula tak F4, yang mula-mula dulu mesti not proper sketch lah. Maybe you can, itulah your friend can ni. Tapi yang bila you want to develop you punya ni. So this one your sketch have to be proper sketching lah. Because ini you need to send to me. Ini I need to evaluate you punya sketching idea. You need to explain your sketching, be able to explain. So, but the point is you need to know how to do sketching. Kalau you don't know how to do sketching, habis lah. If you don't know how to do sketches, how can you communicate? Nanti you want to present your sketching, you want to present. Kemudian, right after next week, kita start evaluating concept. Evaluating each concept. Each concept by team member being evaluated. To tentukan, to make sure which one is the champion. Tu concept evaluation punya stage is on the next week. Okay, by this week, I think you kena dah siap do sketching lah. You dah conduct brainstorming session. Okay, next week guys, I tell you the first meeting tak ada. Kita meet on the today lah, on the Thursday, next Thursday. Pasal I want to give you ample time. Brainstorming session, kita will meet at the 25th. It depend lah, maybe 25th atau tengok macam mana. And 25th, second meeting. Boleh ya, Klan?
Boleh.
Boleh
And the
lah
one
tu.
who nanti that 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 time tu kita evaluated. Eh. Itu I will train you macam mana kita buat concept evaluation. I mean evaluation each individual concept tu kita buat which one will become the your final idea, group final idea. Okay, how do we do sketching? Sketching ni guys, you kena make your tangan ni kena loose lah. Eh. You kena loose you punya tangan. Eh. Dia jangan letak atas. Sketchpad yang proper, yang three sketches tu in A3. Eh. In A3. For sketching, we don't need drawing board. Apa pasal my table top surface not flat. So, you don't need drawing board. You don't need drawing this square, set square. Tak perlu lah. Itu engineering drawing. You need sketching. You need to really on your table top. Like mine because my I need my 3D board because my table surface flat. So, I need my 3D board to. So, make sure you punya hand loose lah. Don't rigid your hand. So, you have to do proper sketching. Okay, that's why you need two version. Eh? You need two version of pencil. But I got another version, HB. HB is the lighter one. Lighter version. Then another one, the darkest is 7B. The mid one, mid tone is 3B. Eh, 3B. Okay, sketching ni, pasal you already learn in your I2D kan? Ada dah learn perspektif tak? Class? I2D dulu.
Apa dia?
Ada buat sketching dulu tak? During your I2D, remember your first year?
Ada, ada.
Ada perspektif tu buat?
Yang titik-titik tu eh.
Ingat titik apa titik ni?
Ingat-ingat lupa tu.
Itulah, lupa kan? Ni saya refresh balik lah eh. Refresh balik. Itu yang problemnya. Sekarang ni korang kena able to sketch. Kalau if you don't know how to sketch, macam mana you want to send, you want to present your ideas to your team member, to your client, third party person, stakeholders, to customer or maybe to your lecturer and so on, to your client. Kan? You want to send your, present your idea to Encik Kadri before you develop final one. You need to see the basic idea of you. So you must able to sketch. Kalau you don't know how to sketch, how can you communicate? How can you present ideas to people? Kalau you cakap by talking, people understand. If you have do proper sketching, you can explain how your things work. That's why you need to sketch properly. Okay, biasanya normally you dah belajar dulu in what we call it in engine drawing. Also, your lecturer train you how to do apa? What isometric kan? 30 degree ada kan? By hand. Eh? Like in my class, engine drawing isometric by hand. Because I need the student to practice sketching by hand, 30 degree. Because any object is a bounding ball. Katakan any object, how complicated a component is a bounding ball. You have maximum length, maximum width, and what is your height? You can simply erase. Kalau you don't apa, you punya hand tak boleh draw vertical, try to practice vertical 30 degrees. Okay, this is isometry. Nampak? Boleh nampak tak saya punya ni? Clear tak?
Nampak tak percaya sikit.
Okay, construction line actually 3B yang lighter version. Tapi for the case of this video, you cannot see I make it thicker lah. Ni you have a construction line. Everything is based on bounding box, kan? Bounding box. Tapi this one is isometric. Isometric also can be acceptable as a sketching. But I want to explain you later is about perspective. Tapi this is isometric. Everything is a bounding box. Bila you dah ada bounding box, you have maximum length width. Every component, any shape of your mesti bounding box. Dia ada bounding area dia lah, bounding box. So then only you can make detail lah. Then you can make detail, you can make detail part of your component. Maybe your component is like this. Then you make a detail. Once kalau you ada bounding box, easy. You can form the shape that you want lah. You can make it. Oh ni, tak apa, it's okay. Actually benda ni you pakai 2B. Saya cakap tadi 2B, 7B. Construction is 2B. Tapi kalau saya buat 2B, you tak nampak kan? You can rotate pen, yeah. You don't need masking tape. We are not doing engineering drawing. We are doing like sketching, yeah. We doing sketching. You can make it proper lah. Yang mana part that you think is yang of maybe one of your component is like this, kan? This is acceptable. This one acceptable. This also can be done as apa tu? Bila you dah ada outline of ini, then only you using your 7B lah, using your 7B. Kalau kalau you pakai typical pencil biasa, you don't feel the good of dia punya pressure, dia punya tone kan, you can feel. Kalau you pakai Skechers, right, I want you to buy Skechers biasa, you will feel the difference. Macam I trace ni pun, I feel the difference compare rather than using typical wooden bezel. You feel eh, kalau you nampak, you will appreciate eh, you punya sketching. It makes like you punya, the flow, dia punya pressure dia is nice. Pasal that pencil is designed for sketching. Okay. Then you outline it by 7B lah. Eh? By 7B. And you have your component. For example, like these are this part of your component. Then you outline it. Tak perlu, I don't want your sketching to be so beautiful as long as it's representable lah. Understand what you mean, class? You present an object, you can see, people can, oh, people convince, tengok, oh, this the component that you're talking, okay, they understand it. Contoh like this lah, so you have an, you punya ni. Okay, this one isometric, boleh, you can sketch you punya ni in isometric mode. Pun boleh, eh, in isometric mode pun boleh. Tapi sebenarnya it's good kalau you don't kalau you nak more natural eh, more realistic, sebenarnya kita go for perspective eh. Perspective is more pasal in dia sebenarnya kita in real world this perspective rather than isometric kan. Isometric is acceptable, you boleh buat juga, you boleh buat iso in isometric boleh eh, it's okay dalam you basically isometric mode boleh, then you erase lah yang mana part you tak nak, okay, as long isometric. Then you can do some shading. Eh? You can do some shading if you want to. This is your one of your component, maybe one of your platform. You can do some shading. Which direction? Is the light direction at this? Which certain part to need to be apa? Certain part to need to be shade. Okay? Certain part need to be shade. Okay. Alright. Apa? Okay. This is apa? Isometric. Pun boleh. Tapi kalau you want to do much better, you go for perspective. Kalau perspective like this guy. Kalau you first time, you tak pernah buat perspektif. Perspektif means you need horizon line tau eh. You need horizon line. Okay, kalau this your first timer, tapi kalau you dah biasa perspektif, you don't need horizon line. Kalau you first time doing perspektif, you need horizon line means you try to practice eh. Kalau normally, kalau I industry design student, the first thing the lecturer do during bark sketching, they ask their student to practice draw horizontal line. Practice sampai you get quite perfect horizontal line. Kalau kadang-kadang some of you crooked kan. Draw horizontal line. Macam I draw this 30 degree. Ya, this based on practice. Kalau tidak sampailah bila tak dapat 30 degree. This approximately 30 degrees. Based on practice. Kan? Macam draw horizontal line. Draw vertical line. Practice vertical line. Vertical line. Practice. Make your hand loose lah eh. Little bit. Okay. Kalau perspective like this. You need horizontal line. Dekat close to the border of paper. Kalau ni for first timer on perspective. You make horizontal line. Okay, tak apa, salah tak apa. You make horizon line, 5%. Okay, horizon line, this horizon line. Perspective because kita view 3D sebenarnya not actually in isometric guys eh. Not actually, okay, we need a middle line lah. Middle line is our vertical. Vertical remain vertical. We are doing 2-point perspective. Kita bukan 3-point perspective. Kita doing product design lah, bukannya architecture eh. Architecture, 3-point perspective. Kita 2-point. So this our middle line of our axis. Macam lah kita punya isometric lah. Isometric. This my isometric kan, this my middle line axis kan. And height 30 degree like this, and 30 degree like that. Tapi this one, kalau perspective, this not 30 degree. Kan, dia bukan 30 degree. Because, okay, let's see this your vertical axis yang, you know, vertical axis here. Okay, this my vertical axis. Okay, and we have vanish point, we are taking. Dia cakap entity tadi, vanish point 1, we have dia sama distance lebih kurang, vanish point 2. Kalau the farther the distance is less distorted your perspective lah. Kalau closer you punya vanishing point ni, you punya too much distorted and not realistic lah. The farther the much better lah, tetapi our paper size is A3 and we can reach until ni lah the most lah. Okay, I want to make a bound, because everything is a bounding box kan. So you katakan you have a bounding box of area. Okay, let's say this my, you make a line, one line is about this angle. Okay, one line, okay, they join kat sini juga. One line, kemudian buat line, another top surface like that. Because everything, when line, kalau isometric, 30 degree, they remain 30 degree parallel. Tapi for perspective, dia kind like they converge to that vanishing point. You punya line here ni akan converge to that point. Dia akan end at that vanishing point. So dia bukan tak parallel 30 degree. Okay, dia converging. It kind like converging. Dia converging. to cloud problem. Kan eh? It kind like converging. Tak apa, you buat sikit-sikit. Tak apa, you buat. Nanti dia converging to that point. I tak buat accurate just pada dia. Okay. Same goes here. Yang ni dia kind like converging. Okay. So you have, nampak tak? You have a top surface. Ini represent you punya bounding board. Okay, the vertical remain vertical lah. Vertical remain vertical. Boleh nampak eh line saya ni eh? Plus. Vertical remain vertical. Vertical remain vertical. Pasal kita 2-point perspective only. Vertical remain vertical. Only the right and the left yang kita perspective. Okay, so katakan this your bounding board. The height is it. This for the height. So, this height, when you have meeting one height, you bukan parallel 30 degree. You can like converging. This side, dia akan converging. Converging, dia akan sampai situ. Okay. Yang this one, dia akan height, dia akan converging sampai dekat situ. Dia akan touch to that vanishing point. Okay, so you punya bounding box is like this. So this your bounding box. Kenapa tak you punya bounding box? This your bounding box. Bounding box of your component you want to sketch lah. Katakan you have, once you have the bounding box, kenapa tak you punya this eh? Yeah, I highlight little bit eh. Tapi sebenarnya construction ni juga you using 3B lah. For the sake of this video, I'm using semua 7B. 7B, so you can see the picture. So this is my bounding box. Tadi kita punya bounding box like this right? Auto apa ni, isometric like that. Tapi dia tak perspektif, dia kan parallel. Tapi tu tak natural eh, tak natural. Tapi natural kita dia kan tak converging. So our bounding box is like that. Okay, this is my bounding area. Bounding box. Okay. So when you have the bounding box, it will help you lah. It will help you nampak. This line also if I join, dia akan, ini pasal I draw tak proper lah dia punya ni eh. Ini pun kalau, pasal tadi my line crooked. You have a bounding box. Ini akan, this line kalau you join, dia akan converge to that point. Ini kan dia akan converge to that point. Bila you have the boundary, they can make more detail. For example, I want to detail. This component is like, for example, like it's tabletop lah. Just take a sample case, tabletop. I think, okay, tabletop ni, it's a table, right? The tabletop thickness here. So this line ni, you make kind like, bukan parallel, dia kind like converging to, dia akan go to this vanishing point. Again eh. So katakan the thickness of your ni, so dia kind like, not that parallel, dia akan converge to. Yang ini pun dia not that parallel, dia little bit, dia become narrower, again go further to the vanishing point. Dia akan, you make it slightly. Tak apa, sebanyak line tak apa, nanti you just pakai you punya construction line yang less darker tu, like 2B only. Kemudian kita ada table leg kan, table leg remain vertical lah, kata this is the thickness of this table leg. Like that, table leg like this. Okay, you got a table leg thickness like this. Okay. Okay, that under table leg still cannot be seen lah. Okay, then you have, bila you ada bounding box, that's right, the point when you have the bounding box, sebab you buat banyak line tak apa, never mind eh. Okay, ini dia punya thickness of the table leg kat sini. You buat banyak, so you outline kan dia. Yang ini also dia punya thickness, this one. Ini naik atas. Vertical tak ada perspektif eh. Vertical no perspektif. Kalau vertical perspektif, small like building. You mean the, also we go down the 3 points perspektif. Tapi itu for architecture. Architecture when you draw building sketching eh, you first eye view looking from the top, memang we have 3 point. Because yang lower to the ground tu dia become narrower. Pasal kita first eye view, yang close at the top tu besar. You want 3 point perspective. Tapi kita product, we go for 2 point only. Bila you dah ada banyak line ni tak apa, mula you nampak macam tak betul. Bila you get the perfect line, okay. You have the bounding box, then yang ini pun saya ada thickness of the leg ni. Saya put around macam dia converging to that point and bring it up. Okay, bila itu dan kita akan detail lah. Then kita akan detail. Bila kita have the construction line, only kita akan darker. Kita trace all the possible part. Okay, actually guys, yang you tak nampak as dark macam ni pasal I'm using all the same pieces. Sebenarnya pasal video ni tak clear kan. So I'm using 7D. Kalau you use 2B for construction, you outline kan you punya. Object line. Jadi tak, the point bukan I don't want to train you guys to become artist, no guys. Actually you can proper eh, you punya sketching idea tu, you can proper do it present in, apa kita cakap, in 3D lah. In 3D. Kalau tidak nanti, some of you, your sketching is so terrible eh, kadang people susah. You have a good idea but you don't know how to sketch. you cannot present your ideas. It's some problem juga, eh? Problem. People not understand what you're talking about. How much you do the talking for, kalau you're sketching, people cannot understand. It's not representable as any to present your idea. So quite a problem, eh? Quite a problem. Then you outline kan apa yang dia punya visible, all the visible line. Okay, ini little bit pasal not in good. My position sekarang ini tidak comfortable dengan. Okay, proper, eh? So you buat dulu, buat tray. Kalau you buat dulu, bila you have a guideline, buat tu dengan construction dulu. For example, you have tabletop lah. You should earlier boleh present lah. Okay. This one perspective lah. Eh, guys, eh? Boleh lah, eh? Faham tak kelas?
Faham.
Okay, one nothing. Bila you buat, ni contoh je lah, one table aja I can show lah. Pasal you punya project ni, lot of component. Maybe you have a compartment, you have a fence. Try to make perspective lah kalau if you can. Kalau tak most, kalau the most, kalau tak cannot produce perspective, you can do isometric mode pun boleh like this. Also can, tapi much better lah. More natural to look is more perspective lah. Katakan you want to show dia punya system, cow feeding device, ada dia punya fence, dia punya area kan. If you draw in perspective, you look more outstanding lah. You can sketch it more presentable, eh? More presentable. In trace. Okay, satu lagi is for another thing. Kalau if you want to make it much better, if you do shading by pencil pun boleh. You boleh shading. Shading ni punya rules like this. Katakan I have a light source ni, eh? Ini light source from here, this direction, yang upper right corner. Biasa an object, eh? Bila kita shading, kerana kalau kita shading kadang-kadang it look more presentable rather than not shading. Rather than macam ni outline, kalau kita put in shading mode, it is much more presentable. Tapi kalau nak buat shading pun bukan nak you nak kena perfect, tapi at least basic by logic lah, eh? By logic kalau rule, kalau kita tengok light source is upper right corner, surface atas ni I perlu shade ke? Top surface table ni, do I shade top surface? Do I shade or not?
Tak payah
pasal that's the more highlight kan. Ini the more highlight. Ini kind kita namakan dia specular. Specular is the most highlight. Okay, biasanya dia dua part, eh. Sharing dia dua part. Satu specular, satu diffuse, satu ambient. Ambient is most the darkest. Ambient ni, any component kalau you ada lighting, you want to do shading, dia ada tiga. Satu specular area, satu diffuse area and satu is ambient. Ambient is the most darkest. Ambient is where area any surface yang not receive light, totally the darkest one. Ambient. The diffuse yang mid-tone, yang tak receive light, not specular, not the most highlight, tak receive. Dia kan little bit ada shading like grey sikit, grey color sikit. And the most yang specular, yang receive light, dia shiny, the flat surface for example, we don't need to shade. Dia pasal dia putih lah, the white. Okay, this is specular. So where is the diffuse? Yang tengah dia kat mana? Yang I perlu shade sikit, kat mana? Which surface? Sepih belah kanan yang sini ke, sepih sebelah kiri? Light source is daripada situ. Are you listening? Okay, kita ada dua sepih. Satu isoplane right, satu isoplane left. Which one darker? Jadi ada dua tone sini. Right,
the left.
Which one is darker?
The left one is darker.
Yeah, you are right. The left is darker than right. Why, eh? The left ni, dia been blocked by ni. Nampak tak? Been blocked by tabletop. Betul tak kan? Pasal dia this side, dia been blocked. The right ni, dia tak blocked by anything. Tetapi dia parallel dengan light source. You mean light source is direction. Dia tak parallel. Macam ni, the rule of lighting macam ni. Eh? Okay. This is your surface. Kata ni, you punya surface. Ni, you punya light source is this direction. Nampak, eh? Okay, your surface ni dengan light source ni, ni perpendicular kan? Your surface tadi, betul-betul perpendicular. So yang ni memang specular, highlight lah. Don't need to shade. The motion ni pasal your surface dengan light dia perpendicular. Tetapi as your surface ni, katakan ini in axis, eh. Katakan as your surface rotated like this. Asalnya axis like this kan? Rotated like that. If dia rotated, then the light source this direction, dia less, dia less specular. Specular getting lower. No more specular. Dia little bit kena shade sikit. Kalau you angle you lagi like this, Lagi less specular lah, you mean kena shade lagi gelap sikit. Kalau and you parallel lah, you portrait, I mean you punya surface is parallel dengan light surface, itu dia lagi little bit darker. Bukanlah ambient. Macam okay, like this surface dengan light source ni, dia tak perpendicular. Nampak tak yang this area? Dia kind dia ada, dia ada shade. Jadi you can shade. Pasal sometimes student, bila ask them to shade, dia simply shade, fill semua, fill in, shade. No, that's no point of shading. Kita cannot see the represent of 3D shading. You need to see like a real, sometimes it looks logic lah. So yang ini, you need to shade lah. You need to shade a little bit. Tapi the less darker than, dia little bit lighter than the left side. Okay. You pakai sketch pencil. Mula you nampak all the ni. Tapi you blend by finger eh. Using your thumb tu. Okay. You blend it. So nampak dia blend. Kalau lebih tu you excessive tu, you erase. You fart. Baru nampak dia menarik sikit. Okay, as we told you, yang left is more darker kan? Pasal left, why left darker? Walaupun say dia perpendicular, tapi walaupun dia perpendicular, tapi dia bukan surface di sebelah, di other side. Dia been blocked by ni, been blocked by the tabletop. Bukan by logic, dia little bit darker. Can make it darker. You nicely trace. Just all by line by pencil. Ini bukan nak mengajar korang budak sekolah rendah cara ni, apa, pilih color. Tak, this basic je eh. You just shade. Tak apa, you just shade, you fill in. Nampak dia smooth. Fill in everything uniformly. Dia little bit darker than the right. Pasal dia been block eh. Dia little bit darker. Little bit darker. Then you blend it by your, you know, finger. Blend it, dia nampak lebih kurang lebih. Outline ni memang kita kena hitam lah. Outline ni kita hitamkan boleh lah. Baru nampak dia represented as a 3D. Okay, satu lagi, what about the table leg yang bawah tu? Table leg yang bawah ni. The surface ni. Okay, this one also, dia become the darkest. Why dia the darkest one? Dia kind like ambient. The darkest one is ambient. Ini kita ada dua kind diffuse. Satu lighter diffuse, dia darker diffuse. Yang bawah ni, because since dia totally block, that become the ambient. That is the most dark lah. Okay, yang ni you kena... Ambient dia the darkest lah. Dia darker. Pasal dia totally dia block by the tabletop. Okay. Block by the tabletop and dia tak receive light. Dia ni. Dia the other side. Baru nampak ada effect sikit lah. Tapi maybe my showing ni tak ni lah. It's not a good example lah eh. Basically you get the picture lah. That's what we call ni lah. Faham tak kelas? Kalau ada shading is good lah kalau you can produce shading. Tapi shading ni tu dia cakap kalau student if I ask them to shade, they simply not based on physics punya rules of lighting lah. Tak kena. Tak boleh macam tu. Cannot be like that. Dia tu define macam ni lah eh. Kalau katakan you have a, tengok sini eh guys. Kalau you have a sphere eh. Sphere. This is spherical eh. Spherical shape. This is your light source from upper right corner. Upper right corner. Kalau upper right corner, so kalau sphere, kalau you want to show you punya sketching, your object ni is a spherical shape. I ask you to shading. Jangan simply fill in solid. That cannot represent a sphere. Betul lah kan? Cannot represent a sphere. So kalau to proper shading, you kena tengok what is highlight, what is diffuse, what is ambient. What is specular, diffuse, ambient. Kalau sphere like this, dia macam ada contour kan? Ada contour. Macam ni. Contour macam ni. Okay, yang the most highlight is dia lah. Highlight pasal ni light source kat sini. Lepas tu as dia go pasal dia spherical surface. As dia go apa ni. Saya so, you punya pencil ni kena sharpen jugalah. Eh? As you go little bit ni, you can use masih little bit like. To blend little bit. Ni adalah diffuse. Saya tak draw properly, sorry guys. Saya tak buat properly lah tapi macam ni dia blend. Tapi as they get little bit lower based on the contour tu kan, they get darker lagi. Macam bulan sabit. Lagi yang paling bawah sekali tu. Paling bawah tu is ambient. Lagi gelap lah. Dia lagi gelap. So dia tak boleh draw dia properly je. Yang the specular tak ni. Alas ni can blend lah. Blend by blend ni. Blend lah. Bo. Eh, kurang lah eh, boleh kurang. Tapi contour ni kalau you erase, pasal tadi saya tunjuk you ada contour line kan. Kalau I erase the control line, you can see ni baru yang ni the specular tu, I will not. The specular, I will not share it. Itu yang nama dia macam tu. Itu yang logik dia. Yang ni specular lah. The most highlight is specular. Yang ni, the mid-tone ni nama dia diffuse. Okay, diffuse. Actually, diffuse is your object color. Katakan this is a snooker ball. A snooker ball, red snooker ball. Or bowling ball. The red, the diffuse represent, pasal bowling ball dia shiny kan. The diffuse tu represent your object color. Kalau red, dia red color. Yang ni, the darkest, the ambient tu. Yang belakang tu, ambient tu dia the dark red. Not close to black lah, not black. Close to darker red. Dia like macam crescent, dia macam blend macam ni. Put the shade. Yang belakang nama dia ambient. The darkest one, we call it ambient. Bahawa kalau you buat macam ni, ni can see as your this is sphere. Pasal banyak student, dia punya bentuk spherical shape. One of dia punya product spherical. Tapi, they show, sir, this the spherical. I cannot see this one as a sphere. What I see, this is a circle. 2D kan? Lepas tu saya cakap, you have got to shade, then just shade. Shade, semua shade. Jadi represent to me again to define this one is sphere. Tak boleh juga, I can see this 2D kan? You cannot fill in shading tu. For my point to shading tu biar logik. Macam ni present shading lah. Then I can see, oh, this is sphere. Why this thing? This thing bukan benda yang remeh-remeh guys. Because what the specular. Specular ada R, specular. Benda ni sometimes you, walaupun you engineer, sometimes you been able ke. Bukan nak train you to become 3D artist. No, to become artist apa like industry to better ni. Tak, at least you punya, you understand what I mean? You punya sketching ni is present. Comfortable lah, can outstanding to make you punya concept sketching nanti, make it outstanding nanti, people tengok or people will understand. You are into sketching, you are into concept ni, I will judge juga the way you punya quality of sketches juga, not just based on functioning. Kadang-kadang if your sketching is good and your explanation of functioning of your mechanism or how you solve that you punya project punya system tu, the way you punya ni lah, your mechanism of your system or your machine. Bisa the quality of sketching also pun play a role juga to help me to understand apa you punya concept. Understand guys? Are you there still there or not?
Yes, I understand that.
Understand? Banyak ramai student dia tak proper sketch, itu problem lah. Bukan itulah Ada student tu yang cakap you, dia punya sketch like this. Yang tak ni lah yang tak proper. Macam budak sekolah cakap dengan you. Can I zoom in lah? Sketch dia macam ni. Awak tahu apa benda ni? Dia nak explain saya. Dia punya one of dia punya component. Takkanlah you nak present. Pasal nanti you buat explore sketch, you a lot of component kan? You punya component sketch. Dia tunjuk. Awak tahu apa benda dia nak explain saya ni? Awak tahu ni? Ini nampak as apa?
Pil.
Nak cakap getah pemadam, nak cakap ubi kentang semua can do kan?
PSP.
PSP pun boleh. Kan? Tapi sebenarnya dia nak tunjuk benda tu adalah silinder. Actually it's a cylinder. Ini yang dia produce. Tak boleh lah. Takkanlah you nak produce sketching macam ni, betul lah kan? At least kalau you nampak saya scan ni cylinder. This one produce ni. This is cylinder, right? Kalau you do proper shading lagi bagus. Maybe your component is small kan? Pasal you explore, you banyak komponen-komponen kecil in your one paper kan? I bukan nak you draw, bukan menarik. At least you can produce lagi. Boleh? One of your component is cylinder. Do some shading. Nampak shading cylinder kan? Dia ada kind ambient, highlight. Lepas tu diffuse and kemudian dia blend together. You outline kan, okay, this is cylinder. Okay, dan kemudian you ada lagi, part lagi. So then you have another component. But can you do, boleh tak you buat macam ni? Sometimes you don't need to, kalau you dah biasa, you don't need to, apa? Don't need to, apa tu, perspective you line tu kalau for starter lah kan, finishing point tadi, nanti you have a ring kat sini. So, proper line you buat ring. Bukanlah nak so beautiful, nak perfect, tapi I can represent. Okay, you have a bush masuk dalam silinder. So you have a guideline. Macam tu lah. Boleh tak dalam you punya concept sketching, you present macam ni? Boleh ke guys? Maybe you can do better than me.
InsyaAllah boleh, Doktor.
Ha?
InsyaAllah.
That's my point. Bila you sketch, sketch it properly. Pasal you design a product kan, you want to present you punya sketching idea. Okay, one of you ask me, sir, why not we use SolidWorks? No. The answer is no. At this moment, no SolidWorks. When SolidWorks comes, SolidWorks comes bila masa. SolidWorks, 3D modeling, this is only concept idea of each team member. Kalau you are using SolidWorks, you wasting your time dulu. I cakap, ini rough idea. You make yourself everything begin on paper. Even you want to do part modeling on cellular work, you need a sketching on paper. Because I memang I saw ask my student, because remember when you do solid work, your engine drawing dulu, first year, you have to buat a project at component-component part modeling. My student, I ask them to sketch dulu on paper dulu, each part. Sketch dulu the component, everything on paper dulu. Okay, my point is now, this is individual concept, no solid work. Solid work comes only after your final design, you punya final concept that win, the champion among your group. You mean you punya group punya final design, then only you develop in part modeling solid work, then you can make proper lah. Pasal solid work, you can produce detail modeling and throws engineering drawing lah. Tapi, it's just initial idea, rough idea of your concept. You want to present. Kalau you punya concept, you present it very nice, then only on next week, then only you present you punya idea, then only each you punya group will do concept evaluation of the team member lah, team member of the ni. Wow, kalau you punya concept sketching tu nicely presentable in perspective or maybe isometric, the shading is much better. You have some component, then only you present to your team member to being evaluated. This normal brainstorming. Ini sesi next week is evaluation, concept evaluation. You mean you punya group have to decide which one will get to give points. The other criteria, nanti I will get you later next week. How we put that, what criteria that we choose to judge each individual concept. Okay. Okay, what else? I think itu saja yang saya boleh tunjuk hari ini. Ada question tak? Macam you ada some component lah, the show, flow, semua kan? Maybe some of you have you ada apa kind like orang punya project ni what macam mana ya, apa benda yang you perlu sketch sebenarnya, tell me exactly apa ni kalau you punya konsep sketch, apa benda yang you kena sketch sebenarnya class
komponen luaran tu.
Betul kan?
Komponen-komponen untuk buat sistem tu, mesin tu, doktor.
Ayolah, komponen-komponen lah. So, you want to present macam mana? You kena present, dia dah bagi you layout, dia punya area, layout plan ada dah bagi dah belum?
Tak salah, saya belum lagi.
You kena catch up lah. Jangan tunggu, bukan saya punya kerja, korang punya kerja, your work, your
job senang mana. Sebab dia tanya dalam group, itu macam dia tak reply lagi.
Tak, you kena personal contact dia lah. Bukanlah, tapi janganlah push dia. Tapi kena in design ni. Dalam you kalau work in a project, project you kena, bukanlah kind of pushing. You kena ada, tak boleh tangguh-tangguhkan lah, nanti lambat. The layout plan tu very important The layout plan tu yang mungkin decide you punya macam mana you want to sketch kan. You punya layout area tu. Macam dia punya cage size tu important tu dalam you punya kan. Betul tak guys?
Betul tak?
Kalau you go for feeding, I think the cage size tu, you need to design, you need to sketch this kandang tu, what's the area kan. You tak perlulah buat sketching area dimension like engineering, no. Tapi basically you get the picture lah. Dia bagi you by meter per meter. You boleh buat lah first kali, okay let's say. If you don't want to go for perspective, boleh. Tak apa, you can go for isometry. This area, you have to be able. You punya sketching more or less, you punya more kepada layout system tau. Layout of plan tu, if I'm not mistaken lah. Okay, this one dia punya, you kena sketch something like this lah. If I'm not mistaken, you punya ni, then you have a lot, you punya boundary area. Betul lah kan guys? Okay. Ni dia punya cage. I don't know, tu lah. Get some input berapa dia punya actually. You make dulu. Make your hand free. Make macam mana you punya. Then kemudian you detail part. So you punya, then kemudian you ada kandang, how you design you punya system, I don't know lah. You make some rough, nampak tak, Mike man? I don't know macam mana you buat nanti, sketching. Ini just a quick one to show you, obviously you get idea lah, okay. You buat dulu, salam tak apa, buat dulu, tak apa. You try dulu, effort dulu bila. Kadang-kadang A3 pun tak apa, do not afraid of wasting paper. You keep practicing, okay. You buat by pakai 2B or 3B. Bila get the flow, the idea, you punya system, you punya macam mana you punya system, you punya compartment on feeding. Dia macam banyak like ni lah. Kalau you not able to perspective, okay to me. Mine is a single component, you want to make more impressive perspective. Actually mine is little bit perspective guys. Mine is not parallel tau, it's like converging. My line ni is not parallel, dia kan converging. Tapi dia converging, vanishing point dia outside my paper. So kalau you dah biasa, you tak perlu perlu horizon line tadi, I show you vanishing point, vanishing point, not necessarily. Because everything is a bounding box. Katakan, I want to draw a cylinder in perspective. Cylinder, nampak tak? My line is not parallel tau, it's not like converging. But the converging point to outside, I know it will be outside. Kalau, if I need a horizon line, kadang-kadang it will be quite distorted. This my cylinder, kind like, this one is kind like, it's not parallel. This is perspective cylinder on horizontal, not vertical cylinder. Nampak? This line actually not, dia not kind like parallel, kind like converging. Ini, this line is actually not parallel, dia kind like converging little bit. Macam bila dia join together, they are outside. So, kita nampak saya sketch ni. Okay. Nampak saya sketch cylinder, nampak? Okay. Nampak my bond,
nampak.
My boundary box ni kalau you join ni, dia somewhere outside. Okay. This is cylinder. No, no, I'm talking about you punya kandang, you punya cage kan kind of perspective kalau you make. Kalau isometric also can do. So you make a layout, kalau cylinder, you can draw cylinder. Okay, this is cylinder. Cylinder, you can at the back macam ni, you can back like that. You have middle point, you have midpoint. Kalau cylinder, you tahu kan buat macam ni. Then you have ellipse, kind like ellipse, iso, circle. Cylinder, here also. Keep practicing lah, keep practicing. Okay, where's tangent point? You join this point. You just put tangent point. Join this point, this tangent point, this tangent point, tangent point. Then join this. Right, sikit sikit sampai get an arc. Yang ni tangent point sini. Tangent point, join this tangent point. Bila you dapat, then you outline by 0.7B. Outline. Tadi saya, I have to show you ni not proper lah. Semua I buat by 7B kan. Pasal you tak nampak kalau I buat pakai 2B je. Yang mana outline ni nampak? Ha? Boleh nampak video ni? Ha?
Boleh.
This is cylinder. Then you erase lah mana-mana part. Tak apa. Kalau you buat by 2B tadi, tak perlu erase. Cuma yang ni je. Okay. Make a proper cylinder shading macam saya cakap tadi. Which one highlight you nak kan? Which highlight the more you get the lower. Darker. Kemudian jadi tu ambient. Ambient is the most darker. Dia macam tu. Blend little bit by your finger. Oh, nampak silinder. Ini sepatut saya erase tadi ya. Ada sekali lagi. Ada line ni pasal dia ni. Okay, so shape sekali lagi. Bo represent as a cylinder. Okay, kalau katakan you punya light source ni, yang ni kena kind of shading juga lah, tapi dia tak normal. Little bit grey, little bit macam tu blend. Okay lah, cylinder rather than macam ubi kentang, macam PlayStation punya. Okay, look something else. Okay, you want to explain something, it look something else. Okay. Boleh tak buat layout plan ni, boleh tak? Macam schematic, you more like a layout of your case lah. I think you most project predict you punya sketching ni lah, tentang location where you punya feeder, you punya container, you punya conveying kan. How, macam mana you want to develop you punya concept ni, you have a lot cell. You don't have to draw properly cow-cow tu, you can make a simple version mode lah. Of course you have a cow inside here kan. You have a lot of cow inside here, tapi tak perlulah draw cow, you can represent anything like a cow lah. Bukan nak draw cow like this ke, like that ke. Boleh lah macam tu, as long it's a cow. I don't know lah, you boleh buat macam mana lah. Okay, it's a cow. Cukup lah, tak perlu. Rather than you have nothing, kena juga draw cow. Tapi some a simple format of cow. Boleh kan, kelas? Hello? Tak apalah, I show you macam mana. Tapi you more as a layout plan lah macam ni. You, how you design. Kalau you tak buat this thing, macam mana you nak sell, you want to present your idea to people? Betul tak kelas?
Betul.
Ah, macam mana? You want to, okay, this is your concept idea. You want to present to Encik Kadri. You want to explain macam mana? Kan? Katakan you nak buat solid modeling in solid work. I bukan tak encourage sekarang, pada dia is the only concept idea. You are wasting your time tau. Nak buat concept modeling in solid work, jenuh juga eh. You have to do part modeling, assemble kan dia kan. Dan kemudian something that is only rough idea dan kemudian belum not final. So you kena judge lagi, validated. So you kena tedious process lah. I suggest for Adamus ni, you buat concept sketching lah. Concept sketching, you can at least, okay. My point tadi, kena, okay, concept sketching tu, why do we need three version eh? Three version tu, you mean your sketching tu. Selalunya macam ni, kenapa we need three version? Satu is full assembly mode. Okay, full assembly mode. Ini full assembly. Okay, full assembly. Kemudian the second, this is the first sketching. The second sketching will be dia dalam keadaan ini A3, dia more like kepada explore. You know what is explore? Full assembly yang macam saya cakap ni lah, you buat semua tu in assembly lah. You just draw dia ni, maybe some other title dia apa. The second sketching tu, dia more like explore tau, explore of component. Kalau dia macam image that you punya, dia ada kind like you identify all the possible component. Where is the container? Where's the location of dia punya narrow path? Dia ada explain tau, dia ada explain apa component ni, nama apa. Ni nama dia apa. Ini ada ni nama dia apa, this one nama apa, ini komponen apa, apa material ke dia kalau boleh kan. Kalau boleh lah, identify all the component possible. You namakan apa, ini more kita explore, identify. Bukan yang ini, you just lay out plan of you punya ni lah, you punya system, you punya ni lah. Or maybe one, you focus on one machine, maybe you want the whole system in the cage. It is, I don't know, it depends on you and your team member. Yang explore mean you pecahan of component, you understand what I mean? You explore what the component ini, what is the name, ini apa dia, actually apa. Kalau boleh can include what material you pakai. Ini material, steel cage, ini ada ini. Understand that class? That is will be the second section.
Ini lukisan explore tu sama dengan lukisan yang first, doktor?
No, full assembly, yeah, it could be the same. Full. Biasanya kalau katakan my project is a device, full assembly you punya device tu in assemble form. Jadi you, yeah, okay, this you punya full assembly. The second ni dia more unexploded.
Oh, you more exploded
into apa komponen-komponen inside. Okay, that is explore. Then you identify, label all the component and the material. Maybe you have spring, you have push, you have shaft, you have apa ni, you have bearing and so on. You have a bracket, can. You have casing, top casing, bottom casing, or left casing, right casing, and you have lah ada ring, ada cap, ada lid and so on. Any part yang you punya sketching component. Kemudian the third sketching itu more explore. That's mean explore. You identify all the components. You label all the components. Tapi your case is like cage kan? I don't know. You punya system. Maybe one machine. Or maybe a system of cage. Satu is full assembly or the layout plan cage tu. Where system. The second is more on. Maybe it's the same as the first. Tapi it's more on like explore mean. Kalau it's the same format as the first also can. Tapi you can more detail. The sketch ni dia more detail on identifying all the parts like the container where is the location. Okay, actually is there in mungkin dalam you punya first sketch dah ada, tapi yang ni more identifying what is the name, more like, do you understand what it meaning like explore mean kita explore more. The first sketching is more like general represent. Kalau you punya case one case lah, you punya sketching is the whole case kan, the whole kandang. The second sketching will be like more like explore. Explore mean like kita explore what is, bukanlah general representation, dia more detail. More detail like expression what component involved. You label what the name of component. You have tank, you have ni, what is the material used. Nampak pasal ni you punya individual concept. This solution lah, this we're talking about solution. Then you have piping, you cakap metal sini, piping, PVC pipe. You ada labeling, ada lot of labeling. Understand tak class? Class, are you listening or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, explore. Itu more explore, labeling and the name of the component. Okay, but the third sketching, that's why basically you 15 points guys, 5, 5, 5. Kalau you bagi one sketching 15 points, tak worth it. Tak boleh. Pasal 15 points in first sketches, so you need divide by 3. So you need 3 sketches. Pasal 3 sketches ni boleh katakan general representation. Kan remember I show you slide tadi, satu explain and satu explore. Tapi saya tambah satu lagi, satu full assembly. Full assembly, satu explain punya sketch, satu lagi, full assembly, satu. You punya buatlah layout plan cage tu, semua ni. Adalah title, mungkin you ada description a bit. The second one, mungkin sama like you ni, tapi more on explain all the part. Identifying all the part, explain the part, explore the part. Labelkan which is tank, which is the conveying system, ni apa kan, which is the cell. This new one tak ada no need dimension kan, not detail legend dimension. You identify all the possible component and part. Ini macam you lah identify all the component that involved dalam you punya system. Clear tak? Explore. This one called explorative sketch. Understand tak? Clear guys?
Clear.
Okay, third. And this sketch number 2. Third sketch will be, the sketch maksud dia explain. Explain mean, the sketch mean, explain. Explain mean, how can you make this sketch to explain how it works? Faham tak? Maybe can be same format like this. In A3, how can you make a sketch to explain the punya flow, the cow entering the cell, kemudian the feeder will you like can you punya sketch ni macam maybe the same, I don't know, maybe the same version like your second sketching or maybe the same like your first sketching, I don't know, maybe different format. Dan kemudian dia kan dia kanlah ada flow dan macam ada arrow dia kan, the cow entering this, wow, so you make a little bit cow lah, then this will be the cell. You ada explain tau, you be explain your sketching, not just your sketching ni have ada kan like explaining macam dia punya step or process, explaining how you punya system work, dia macam ada flow macam ni. Dan kemudian you ada component sketching like maybe like this one, tapi you tunjuk dia ada sketching dia more, and because the point is explaining how your system work. So it is your creativity, how you do it is up to you, you punya format. Tapi you punya sketching ni, you punya maybe layout one machine or maybe the whole case tu macam mana, how you can explain how dia it can, you can show when you present to people, you present to client, you present your team member, because your three sketches need to be present next week to for your and team member to evaluate each concept. Kalau you produce only one sketch, only one full assembly, tapi macam mana people want to understand based on one full assembly aja, you need another version of sketches. You, even your team member also need to know you punya sketches, what is dia punya component set, how it works. This one bukan hanya for your team member, for me tu nanti I will judge also this one. Nanti you kena ada present guys nanti after semester break, if I'm not mistaken, you kena present you punya nanti what you punya progress. So each one of you got to present individual concept. Pasal itu yang I akan evaluate based on your presentation. That one I will give the 15 points tu macam mana lah. Not just mechanism, the quality of sketching also effect lah. Macam I explain, sketching tu must be nicely present lah. And also tapi main thing sebab the mechanism you punya functioning of you punya system. Clear tak guys buat ni? Full example, explore, explain. Explain ni banyak illustration lah. Tak apalah, you don't need to be so beautiful, not to be not too detailed lah. Tapi it's your creativity. How can you do that? Yes, you sketches. Tapi your sketching ni, I don't think it will be 2D lah. Like 3D lah, explain to you lah. Betul tak guys kan? Either you want to do ISO or ni. You cannot show schematic diagram. You know, schematic diagram is 2D kan? Kalau you nak combine, it's up to you. Tetapi I more in on you can present in ISO or perspective view lah. Clear tak?
Clear, clear. Clear
boleh kalau boleh itulah cerita. Okay. So that's how it goes on. Okay, boleh boleh buat So kalau boleh buat, the first thing to do, kau conduct right after this class, kau conduct brainstorming on your, I hope you punya morphology kecap already done, completed. From there you get some, each one you can develop your own ideas. Conduct a brainstorming. I encourage you guys lah, kalau boleh each one ada two concept. Saya cakap kalau two concept, two sesi brainstorming lah. Macam tu. Kalau three concept much better, tapi three sesi brainstorming lah. Okay, do brainstorming. Itu brainstorming tak ada, not shape, not this kind of sketching dulu. Brainstorming just one single piece of A4, just rough idea lah. Boleh kalau you sketch. Ini yang brainstorming tu pun itu kind like explain tau. Masih ni, I remember brainstorming to one piece of A4 paper. Macam you can be able to sketch like explain nanti bila you go to, kalau you can produce one piece of A4 yang ni, macam ni lah juga. Tapi yang ini I want it to proper lah. Kan? Pasal during your brainstorming, you buat in single piece A4, saya cakap very rough lah. You can do ISO purpose. You can do any kind of version of sketching, tapi you pass around to your member. Member you will evaluate and they give positive value added. Tetapi kalau your sketching is cannot be understood, you don't know how to sketch, macam mana your friend nak evaluate dalam brainstorming also, kan? Problem juga kan, betul tak guys? Betul tak? Hello? Faham kan? Jadi yang single piece A4 brainstorming tu you been able to sketch. Bukan cakap sketching tu bukan hanya setakat A3 saja, tapi yang after brainstorming tu, bila you go back, you receive balik you punya sketching being evaluated by four or your team member, you give positive, okay, give a new idea for you to make you punya concept better, make improvement based on their positive comments. And that's why I want you to need draw yang proper this in A3 full assembly. I need to know ini after brainstorming. Tetapi that brainstorming tu pun you need to produce at least one sketch. Kalau you don't know how to sketch pun, tapi that single piece A4 sketch tu pun is kind like explain punya sketching, not full example. Maksudnya kalau you bagi full example during brainstorming, you send full example, people nak say ini just example drawing, how it works, macam mana orang nak judge. that single piece of paper, itulah, saya cakap, brainstorming itu not necessary maybe one single piece effort, maybe two piece, it's up to you. Tapi biasa brainstorming ini dia single piece lah, kalau tengok ada single piece paper saja, tengok kita. Pasal tu rough idea dulu, rough idea. To be careful about that lah, bila brainstorming pun you have one piece of effort tu, basic, you have rough sketching lah, okay lah. Ada some explanation, bila you present dalam brainstorming, you send to student B, your team member B, dia tengok, dia boleh understand, then dia give. Pasal brainstorming, bila you go, you pass to him, brainstorming you tak boleh discuss dengan dia tau. Ah guys, faham tak? Walau you embrace, you understand what I mean? You boleh dah discuss, tapi sebenarnya brainstorming macam ni, you pass around, sit down, you pass around, you give. Dia macam loan, you understand tak? Brainstorming tadi dia kind like, dia supposed to be macam tu. Brainstorming tadi.
Kira orang lain tak boleh interrupt kita tak ke?
Dia tak, dia kalau interact tu dia dah jadi, dah kacau, dia bukan nak pure brainstorming lah, boleh lah juga. Tapi dia macam, dia brainstorming ni, you pass around, you sit down, dia quiet sekejap. Masing-masing evaluate masing-masing. Macam tengah exam, tahu tak? Like you are in the middle of exam. Lepas tu stop, okay, think habis masa. Jadi ada host lah seorang. Okay, pass rest sekejap apa, okay, pass around ni, pass kepada ni pula. The rest dia. Dia tengok dia ni. Ah, itu brainstorming supposed to be macam tu. Tapi kalau you're sketching tu, people tak faham dia nak comment macam mana. Ah, itu yang problem tu. Betul tak? Nanti, bila dah sampai back to you, you punya dah sampai, dah, itu dah boleh jadi macam not brainstorming, you boleh discuss. Tak, it's up to you lah. I tak cakap brainstorming must be like that. It's up to you how you want to handle it. Tapi you need to do brainstorming as I told you. Okay? Ada question tak? Ada apa-apa question? I think that's all I want to talk about lah, tak ada apa lagi. Kelas, are you there? Assalamualaikum. Yang lain apa? Senyap yang mana ni? Berapa
orang? Ada. Assalamualaikum.
Ada apa-apa question?
Okay, doktor. Yang pencil tu 7B, 3B dengan HB ya?
Best minimum dua version je lah. 2B dengan 7B lah, saya suggest you.
Kalau 2B dengan 7B?
HB pun boleh juga. Tiga version, macam saya ada tiga lah. Tak apalah macam ni, tak macam ni. I guess in simple one. 7B dengan 2B or 3B. 2B tu you buat construction. Yeah? 7B ni yang outline kan dia, the finishing. The finishing outline ni by 7B. Saya cakap you.
Thank you, Dato.
You buy this one, you feel the different. Kalau you beli common pencil, you tak appreciate sangat. You tak nampak nicely. Bila you buat sketching pun, you rasa tak seronok. You don't feel good of sketching. Pasal your pencil quality is not good. That's why I cakap, go to cakap dia, professional sketching pencil. I think you bought RM3. Mahal sikit lah, RM3 sebatang. Bukan mahal pun kan? Kan? RM3 sebatang. Dia perlu beli rokok sebatang RM1, itu lagi kerja bodoh. Betul lah kan? Beli pencil sebatang. Betul lah kan?
Kalau untuk shading kita boleh guna mana-mana je tradewing kata.
Shading tak, saya buat mana-mana je shading. I pakai 7B, tapi shading ni ialah you blend dengan tangannya lah. It's your creativity lah. Mana-mana pun boleh.
Okey kata.
Mana-mana you shading. Nice lah, as long shading tu is a good kalau you have lah. Kalau tak ada shading pun to me is okay. Shading tu dia nampak more outstanding lah kita nampak. Compare dengan tak ada shading. Okay, yang penting itu sajalah, you punya sketching ni. Sketching you penting. Nanti kalau you present you punya work, people understand apa you punya concept. Itu yang the most important. Tapi to do that, you must able to sketch. Bukan I want to train you to become an artist. No. Bukan so beautiful, tak. As long you punya sketching tu can read, people can understand. Understand tak? You don't have to be beautiful pun, tapi as long they can present you punya ideas tu. Understand tak guys?
Understand tak?
Okay, boleh tak satu lagi saya nak cakap, satu bab je saya nak cakap. Bila nanti minggu depan you dah buat sketching, after brainstorming you buat 3D sketching kan, you buat 3D sketching lepas tu minggu depan, okay, kita don't have class, you punya class on Tuesday kan? Kan? Supposed to be on Tuesday kan? Tak ada, we don't have Tuesday, yes. Tak ada class. Kita will meet on today, Thursday. By that Thursday tu, each one of you dah ada 3 sketches tu. Boleh tak? Until. Boleh buat? tu after the hasil from your brainstorming tu, you dah get back you punya sketching been commented by you punya all team members, then you make enhanced version to this. I need to see this. Boleh tak? By next Thursday.
InsyaAllah boleh, Doktor.
Ha, cuba eh. Okay, lepas satu lagi yang attach tu, tentang yang slide ni, tak ada buat yang slide yang saya tunjuk. Ada nampak yang slide tadi yang tentang sketching ni?
Boleh.
Okay, ada satu bab lagi sini kita tengok. Persuasive sketching. Apa pula persuasive sketching? Persuasive sketching ni bukan masa sekarang, nanti dulu. Persuasive sketching ni, are you listening or not, class?
Yes, saya tak listening.
Persuasive sketching ni maksud dia persuade. Maksud dia persuade apa? Ini bukan you punya individual sketches, not yet. Ini basta nanti, next week, you bring you punya individual sketches. Okay, we akan go sesi bukan brainstorming. You will go through, you record juga boleh activity. Concept evaluation, you kena nanti I teach you. Evaluation metric dengan PO metric. Itu you evaluate, dua stages. Nah tu, after the second metric tu, you will decide who's become the champion. Maybe champion doesn't mean yang loser tak ada. Bukan hanya the winner saja, dia shock lah, dia menang kan. Mungkin ada combined ideas. Misalnya itu group punya decision. Dia based on, actually based on highest point lah. They will become the champion. After evaluation, concept evaluation, then you have the final. The point you have the final sketch, your final idea. That become your final idea. Okay, that final idea tu, you also have to do sketch. Itu that final idea tu, you have to do persuasive sketching. Itu yang nanti, this is your group punya output. Okay, from your punya through brainstorming, morphology chart, brainstorming and the pursuit concept evaluation of each team member punya concept, then you get which one is the champion. Okay, that's your final idea. Okay, that final idea tu, that is you punya group punya product lah at this moment lah, group punya hasil. You punya, that will be your group output. This is our group punya final idea. That final idea need to be, then you need to produce that. Itu later on, bukan now, I just mentioned to you. Because in this slide, itu need to be persuasive sketches. That final idea tell you, then only you go for solid work. Then only you gonna, siapa one of your team member is strong on solid work, do it. Maybe you can join together, do it together. With CAD modeling and you can do rendering. Itu I will teach you later how you kita buat visualization. Itu later. Itu will be your final idea. Nanti saya ada slot video YouTube, I will show you. Not now. Itu next 2 weeks. Okay? After you have final idea nanti. Ada video, ada buat, ada record video. How you can do solid work, you transfer to KeyShot, you render. Very easy the software tu. Then you make you punya final idea tu impressive. Rendering, 3D rendering. Tu supaya look convincing. Kan you akan show Mr. Kadir. You akan show your Mr. Kadir, your punya client, you want to persuade, make sure. Nanti kita ada competition kan kalau I'm not mistaken. Ada dana if I'm not mistaken eh. Ada tak dia mention eh. Dia akan provide you dana tau, I don't know. Kalau you online, physical, tapi that's what I heard. Maybe kind like a competition. Nanti kalau you can persuade, you show you punya tu client, dia akan tengok you punya hasil kerja. Mungkin dia tengok dengan ada 3D rendering. Nampak tak? Persuasion ni nampak tak? Dia ada cakap 3D rendering. Ini yang maksud dia kita try to persuade. I mean, ni bukan sketching tangan lagi lah. Ini you punya final idea punya group. Ni yang you buat modeling 3D. Ini saya ada video, I can show you. I can guide you how to do this. Yang ni kan you produce 3D rendered image. I mean, you send to your client. You, masa you doing presentation to me also, kalau you ada benda ni, it's kind of persuade. Nampak tak dia persuade? Persuade mean you try to make it impress. Kalau compare dengan the other team member yang lain, patut kau dapat another session kan, they are not on that, they just on sketching. Tapi you guys, you show in 3D, dengan ada rendering, your final idea, you show to your client, and you can look more convincing, you make you punya concept more outstanding. Tetapi you punya concept dengan concept dia sebenarnya sama je, more or less is the same. Tapi you make it like more impressive, outstanding by you ada 3D. Benda tu meyakinkan, to convince your client that your system work because based on your kind like persuade. That's the idea of persuasive. Make it more clear in slide. Eh? The last one ni, persuasive sketches. Okay guys, okay, tapi yang ni tak apa. Yang at this moment you bukan sampai tahap tu lah. Itu bila final idea nanti, you punya group punya champion nanti. That one we need, and I will guide you later. Okay, alright.
Okay, Doctor.
Okay, so can you on the next Thursday lah. Okay, hold on for your attendance. Tunggu je, line slow sikit ni.
Okay, dah tu.
Yeah, hold on for your attendance, hold on. Ini. Cuma jangan lambat sikit nak buka. Okay, scan your attendance, class. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, Doktor.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, Doktor.